So we got Flip playing some Spencer? Or did just button
that,
checking?
I think that's Miguel playing Spencer. He says he's going to try him out, and if he does well on stream, he's going to pick up Spencer as a character.
Okay, so he's using Team Chris G. And it's actually switched, so DJ Flip is actually using some Sea Viper action, so...
Right, yeah. That is is Flip's team, so...
Yeah. He says he really likes Viper, and he's been improving it a little bit here and there.
Right.
But let's see how Miguel does with the Spencer team, and it really looks like it's Team Chris G, to be honest.
Yeah. I mean, I feel like, you know, Miguel could have promise with Spencer as long as he just keeps working on it, because he said that he doesn't know him very well. And basically, I hope he does pick him up, because it is a cool, you know, it's a cool character. And Miguel's been looking for a new character to pick up for a while, so...
Oh, damn right. He should be looking at it, because he's been playing against Jizzleman from, like, back over at
right.
some Rambats ago.
Right,
and
Jizzleman as a Spencer, right?
Yeah, he's one of my homeboys, too, right. So back over at 707.
Yeah.
So, anyway...
I think I fought him a couple times. He's tough, man.
Yeah. Once he gets the hit and goes for mix-up,
oh, yeah.
That's just crazy. But we got a lot of drop combos just because of unfamiliarity of, I guess, with Spencer. Now he just...
Right.
Oh, he's got to go through with this one. Oh, wow. Okay. I would not have done that.
Not very familiar
with Spencer. I would have, just to be honest, with a Wolverine uppercut, because he had a really big start up with that. And that's really risky, just ziplining straight across the screen like that. You could just get air grabbed.
Right.
Okay, so he's using bar, DJ Flip, and getting grabbed, so he's got to get kicked the hell out.
Yeah.
I love this song. You like this song too? Foot dive. Oh, we messed up the song right there.
Thankfully, Switch Spencer.
Wow. Okay. Interesting. Confirmed by DJ Flip, and it's really just pressing buttons.
Yeah. Flip. You know, Flip's getting better. He's still a beginner, pretty much.
Yeah. So. It seems like when I met him about like a year ago.
Right. I mean, I definitely respect that he's interested in Viper. You know, like if he can master that character eventually. You know, I would be proud of that guy, because seriously, Viper is pretty hard to use in any game.
The thing is with Viper is that you have to know when to get in and when not to go in.
Right.
And also, like, usage of meter, like, you have to really convert your setups along with her. So, yeah. I mean, Sentinel's cool. I don't know about Wolverine, to be honest, but I really would actually have, like, a Strider or a... that's a good one right there. Oh, wow.
Oh, yeah.
That was unfortunate that the Doom Missiles were in the way.
Doom Missiles beats everything.
There we go. That's a really good conversion. Oh, no. Oh, he should... Don't push buttons. Yeah,
oh, wow.
Good stuff.
Okay.
And he should super jump that. Just get away from that pressure and also get... avoiding that... Oh, my gosh. He should have just done dive kick, to be honest.
Flip had a pretty good chance, but it's looking worse for him right now, but...
Not sure why Miguel just didn't decide to just kill him right there. Oh, that is a weird confirm right there.
Okay, so...
And he's going to put him in a shower.
He does not kill Sentinel.
And uses the butter gun. That's, you know, that's really good as an anti-air. Like, for those that can't really super jump high or so. Oh, wow.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, only that EX Thunder Knuckle is only good, like, probably like half screen. Not full screen. And we've seen like something that like that happen against Noel Brown versus K-Beast, and that was unfortunate, but...
Right, I think I caught that, yeah.
Over at NCR, yeah.
Yeah. And, man, okay. Flip trying to do something.
Oh, he's going crazy. That's what I like to see.
All right.
He's going to come out, yeah. And... Yeah, it just gets bops.
His Sentinel still has a chance as long as he stays calm, does not panic about getting hit. Like, oh.
Yep.
Well.
2-0 so far. And gotta drink that Jesus juice.
Well, it is hard to outmaneuver Wesker with Sentinel. So,
hard to I don't think Sentinel's really much of a comeback factor.
Right, yeah.
But aside from, like, you know, like players like Infrared or... Whoever, you know, They make it work.
Although he does hit hard enough sometimes to where if you get an errant hit and you have X Factor, you're good.
Yeah. Like the good thing about Sentinel is that
even without X Factor, he does pretty damn good damage.
Yeah. I'll give that to that. Okay, so he's just every time he's getting out from that that mix up, he's just getting pushing buttons. Okay, that's a weird combo right there. I would not suggest doing that with Doom. Oh, he does not get the confirm from before. And Flip needs to do something. He needs to do like a standing B, because that has like one hit of armor.
Right.
And if Miguel, oh, there we go.
Flip's Wolverine, I would say, is probably his best character. But you know, that's kind of a testament to Wolverine being a simple character to pick up. And
I would really not. I want not do any unsafe drill claws. Oh, you should have just gone for another combo. But I guess that does the job done.
Right.
No, that is not what you should be doing.
Okay.
You should focus on actually grabbing him.
This should be it if, as long as. Okay.
Oh, yeah, this is gonna be it. He's gotta probably do a level 3. Or maybe not. And that's it.
Hopefully, Miguel keeps doing well with Spencer. I would like to see him pick up a new character. It would be interesting. He's been playing the same team for a while now, so.
Yeah, I mean, like, the typical team scrub, Magneto, Virgil, Wesker is always good depending on what order you want it.
Right.
Yeah, so that's always good. Wow.
And
this is
true to form.
Very quick and already in the middle of the bracket, second round.
Right.
That we got Justin and Miguel playing against each other. These two are, I believe, training buddies.
Right, yeah. And I'm not sure if they are, but
from Miguel going back up right now,
he does like 5 games in a row every time he's in a tournament.
So what's the record so far, like, from last results? Were you here last week?
Oh, for every placing, like, for the season?
Well, from just, like, last week in general.
Last week, for Marvel, Justin got first.
Okay.
I got second. I think, I'm not sure beyond that, like, I think that Miguel might have got third. I'm not sure, but I don't really know.
I mean, it seems like you guys are, like, the top three right here for Marvel.
Maybe. I'm not sure. I got first once. I'm hoping to. Oh, is Vinny? Okay, so.
Oh, what a fraud.
Vinny got third.
What a fraud.
Vinny with his gay ass commentary got third.
Well, he just gave me $20 today, so it's all good.
Yeah.
So, regardless if I win this or not, or. Take a placing of top 3. Doesn't matter to me. I got $20 from Vinny. Right. I'm good to go.
Exactly. Shoutouts to Vinny for his distracting ass commentary.
So it looks like I didn't know that Justin goes by Taco Beast.
I think he was saying something like he used to go by that, and like that was one of his earlier names, like on Xbox Live or something. I'm not really sure where that comes from, but he's gone by different names like pretty much each and every time. The past few weeks. So.
Well, he just killed Zero, which is one of the main problems of that team.
Well, yeah, I mean. Justin isn't Vinny in that regard. Like, if you kill Justin Zero, he's not done. I don't mean to blow up Vinny this much, but seriously.
Here comes Virgil. Oh.
Okay.
I don't know if Justin or. Knows about the round trips glitch where, you know, when you release it and you teleport, it starts going around. So basically, if you throw up on top, the round trip goes around, right? And if he teleports behind him at the exact same moment that it's in the middle, it'll come back, swinging back to the other side where Virgil is. So that's one trick of Virgil that's really good at being solo.
That's pretty interesting. I don't know a damn thing about Virgil, honestly. Like,
you should, because he's fucking top tier in this.
Yeah, he's kind of important to know about.
Okay, so the thing about swords is that is invincible in projectiles except to the head. So if you hit him in the head, or you bop him in the head, you go away.
Right.
Well, that's really not good.
Okay.
For oh, there we go. Looking capitalize
really tough
on this.
For Justin.
And one thing for sure is that with Double Trigger, he can whiff normals and go into different specials. So, like, for instance, he just whiffs, like, a C. He could go straight into Fireball, like, really quickly.
Right.
And that's really good. Oh, damn. Look at that. Look at that comeback.
Oh, man.
I love this character.
Pretty. I guess I would say it's unexpected, but it's Virgil. So.
But the thing is, like, if, like, you know, the fact that X Factor is in this game.
Well, yeah.
Yeah, it's just really a pain in the ass.
Yeah, the fact that X Factor and Virgil are in this game together is
don't
really.
Don't forget Wesker, too.
Wesker, too. Zero, surprisingly, not as much.
Zero's okay. Yeah. It just only depends on the people that have actually used the cheap shit, which is the lightning loop.
Right, exactly. Like, yeah, you could kill in, like, a combo for almost any character, but. With X Factor, it's surprisingly, he's surprisingly, like, just okay.
And it's a really bad matchup for Zero, to be honest, against Super Skull. The fact that he has so many tools to, like, smack him out of the air or even, like, get onto the other side quickly with Meteor Smash, even it's unsafe, it's really bad for Super Skull, but. Yeah. Or bad for Zero, sorry. But
yeah, it's.
But he manages to get some out.
Yeah,
and well, gets the mix-up.
I think Justin knew what was going on with Super Skrull being in there. He realized that Super Skrull has tools.
And he's just got to keep it going. This is apparently this is not his main team, I guess. I don't know.
I'm pretty sure it is. Like, he says it's not, but I don't really believe that. He uses it all the time, and it's probably his best team. I mean, as you can see, his Zero is really good. Like, he can lightning loop as much as he needs to most of the time.
Let's see what we can do against Dante. He might just eat it.
Yeah, it looks like he's already doing that.
Maybe you want to see a DHC? Or nope, not even. Just fuck it. Ground pound and get the bound. And we've seen Miguel come back from losers many times.
Right, yeah.
So it could be possible that he could come back.
Yeah, it definitely can. But then again, Justin himself, he came back last time against me. He brought back the entire Grand Finals against me.
And so what was your team?
My team is what my team always is. It's Captain America, Iron Fist, and Arthur.
Oh, okay. Yeah, it seems like we played before, and
yeah.
The problem I feel is actually Captain America.
Yeah.
Because I mean, I played Spider-Dan, and he's like one of the best like Arthurs, but it's just to a point where he's so hard to beat that you can't reach to his Arthur.
Yeah.
And by the time you get to his Arthur, it's really exhausting to play against, like, you know, Taskmaster and Hawkeye, but I feel like your team is, like, really designed very well with Captain America.
Right, yeah. And, well, I mean, I've been trying to break out of playing Cap predictably. Really just trying to mix things up a little bit more and make sure not to call assists so much.
Yeah.
It's a beginner's hurdle to get over. Like, it's something everybody has to do.
You just have to have some smart reads for sure.
Yeah.
And let's see, like, if Justin can get the follow-up.
Yeah, I think Justin's got this.
But he does not get the follow-up.
I think Justin's got this regardless. He's got Dante and Virgil against a very weak Sentinel. This is looking very good for Justin.
I would rather have Virgil first, aside from Dante. Just because of the comeback factor, but the fact that, like, Virgil really gets supported a lot from Dante back.
That's true.
And also, Virgil gives a lot of much more damage than Dante. Aside from, oh wow, get smocked the fuck out. And nicely done by Justin. Yep. 3-0 against Miguel.
Very good. It's hard to argue against Virgil Anker, though.
Yeah.
Hard to argue.
So, how do you feel about Virgil Anker?
I feel like, fuck this game. That's what I feel like.
So, you really don't like Virgil Anker?
I really don't like it. But I realize how good it is. I mean, that's why I don't like it.
I really like Virgil first or second, to be honest.
Right. Well, I mean, that's the thing. With Virgil, he can fit practically anywhere on a team. It doesn't really matter all that much with him. He's got so many tools, you know?
Yeah. All right, so that's kind of weird.
All right, I got to...
Oh, we're playing against each other?
Oh.
Oh, okay, yeah. Okay. Cool.
All right.
All right, good luck to you.
Good luck to you.
Thank you. first one is... Way to go.
Thank you.
is the Mean American Army. No, that was winner. Flip.
Give me some respect, man.
GP?
Devin and Reggie.
Alright, what's up guys? Riken Army back on the mic, along with Miguel.
How's it going, dude?
Pretty good. I got my homeboy JP Brigance repping it up with Doom right now.
Is he from 707 as
yeah,
well?
Yeah, he's from 707. He's been actually going to school at over at San Diego.
Okay.
I've been learning around with the Box Arena and all that shit. Actually been in a production before with them, so it's like, it's all good and all that good stuff.
Yeah.
A little bit of thing about to know about JP Braganza is that he's really a Doom player. He really,
oh, really?
Likes playing Doom. More into that innovative Doom and all that good stuff. So
that's cool. Personally, I think Doom's one of the best characters in the game.
Yeah,
I play some top three.
I think, to be honest, I think top 10. To be honest.
Okay.
But I put Viper as top three.
I see. And they're both going at it right now. This should be the end, though.
Yeah. And normally,
he mashes it out.
Yeah, he normally mashes it out with one button. And it's a 3 out of 5.
Yeah.
So.
3 out of 5.
So he gets 2 wins on that one.
Yeah.
Normally you'd be always ending the Doom time with like stand heavy, and sometimes like kind of juggles away. You know.
Really?
And I told him, you know, it's better to do M right after.
Yeah.
So if ever you're doing Doom time, you want to make it secure. You want to cancel it at the first hit.
Especially against Sentinel. It's really hard to hit it on Sentinel sometimes.
Yeah, it's kind of weird that he does have a big hitbox, however, when he gets onto the ground.
Yeah, it's weird.
Yeah.
Because he has such a big hitbox that all of his hitbox has to be above the ground.
Yeah.
That's why.
And he's just grabbing away, so...
It's the same when I try to learn Spencer combos. That's why I know.
Yeah.
Because they don't work very well on Sentinel.
Oh, yeah, that's
a good...
Oh,
was it too early?
That was a nice call.
Okay. Not going to be able to kill, but take that half-life.
But I really, really suggest not doing that.
Unless it's going to kill.
Yeah.
Or you're in the corner.
I'd rather do it for a kill, like, for sure. Yeah. Matt, he's just putting rocks on this guy.
The Dirty Snow? Anti-air? Okay, good hard time.
Dirty Snow just because he's black?
What? No, it looks like Dirty Snow when he grabs him.
Yeah, that's true.
Oh. There it is.
One thing about Viper is that she has invincible, like, use of... When she's using meter and all that good stuff.
Yeah, yeah. She could make a comeback. She really could. I mean, I don't know her combo potential with drones, but she could do a lot.
One thing with DJ Flip is that he should really work into getting quick overheads than just spamming lows.
Oh, yeah. Work on those tri jumps. Yeah.
Yeah, you got to work on those. See, if you're a Viper player, you got to really know when to use those and... create a weird situation for your opponent.
Oh yeah, like Marlon Pot likes to do the straight air dash down into standing light for the low hit.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, that's what he likes to do.
Not many people know about that, but
yeah, it's
standing standing A is actually a low. So same thing with scroll. So
yeah.
And JP takes that one. Not sure what's happening right now, but we're gonna get your matches coming up very soon on the side. We got
We got
Justin and Royce just playing some casuals on all the good stuff. Oh.
Yeah.
So it looks like you and Royce, I put Royce in losers.
Oh, really?
Very convincingly. I didn't think I would do that, but that's kind of weird.
Yeah, I don't know, man.
It would have been a different story if he used his Viper, but.
That's true.
Well, we're going to see what's going to happen. Good luck.
Thanks.
And sit back, guys. And we're going to get Roy Mills and Miguel onto the stream. This is really surprising, having them around first or second round in losers. One of these players could actually take each other out, and that was really interesting. So
Welcome to the world of Marvel with Capcom 3, where the finest heroes assemble. Get ready for the fight of your life. Thank you. Situation. yourself. Give me. There you go.
No respect, Miguel.